In this illustration, we'll discuss about the skidding of an accelerating car. Here we are given that a car starts moving from rest with a constant tangential acceleration A1 along a circular track of a radius R. And we are given that the friction coefficient between tires and road is mu, and we are required to find the distance traveled by the car before it skids on the track. Here, if I draw the track, a circular track on which a car is moving, say if this is the car, it is having a tangential acceleration A1 due to which the speed of car continuously increases. That means for this tangential acceleration, a force is continuously acting on it. So, in this situation, a force would be acting on it in tangential direction, which is imparting an acceleration A1. And due to the speed v, it is also having a normal acceleration, which is an, acting directed toward the center of the circular track. As on car, there is no external force, it is only due to the friction on wheels. So these two accelerations are provided by friction. So this is the resulting direction in which its total acceleration exists, that will be the direction of friction acting on it, and which is imparting tangential as well as normal acceleration. Here we can write the speed of car after traveling a distance s is, this can be given as root 2 a1s, because a1 is the tangential acceleration, and if it has covered a distance s along the track, the speed can be given by root 2 a1s, and friction on car can be written as this m multiplied by the total acceleration, which can be written as root of a1 square plus a normal square. And we know that normal acceleration is always equals to v square by r. So we substitute this m root of a1 square plus v square by r whole square. And we can substitute the value of v square as 2a1s. So the value of friction we are getting is m root of a1 square plus this 2a1s by r whole square. So here we can write the car will skid when the value of this friction, which is ma1, and under the root 1 plus 4s square by r square, will be equals to the limiting friction, which is here mu mg, as the normal reaction acting on car by ground is mg only. So on simplifying, if we square it, this will give us mu square g square, as here m gets cancelled out. Mu square g square is equals to a1 square 1 plus 4s square by r square. Further simplifying, this will give us the value of s as, I'm just leaving it for you to simplify the equation and get the value of S, which is R by 2 root of mu g by A1 whole square minus 1, which is the final result of the problem, the distance traveled by car before it starts skidding.